If you think you are beaten, you are. If you think you dare not, you don't. If you'd like to win but think you can't, it is almost a cinch that you won't. If you think you'll lose, you're lost. For out of the world we find, success begins with a fellow's will. It's all in the state of mind. If you think you're outclassed, you are. You've got to think high to rise. You've got to be sure of yourself before you can ever win the prize. Life's battles don't always go to the stronger or faster man, but sooner or later, the man who wins is the one who thinks he can. So this poem was written by Walter D. Wintle, and it has influenced me throughout my entire high school experience. It has helped me with my ADHD, being positive and being confident and people accepting me. I have always struggled with my ADHD because I've been very embarrassed about it, thinking that it takes me a little bit longer to learn a concept rather than my classmates who can pick up on it right away. I also have a problem with having the confidence of being accepted by others. I have always had the fear of bullies, I've always had the fear of people judging me, and LSD has really helped me throughout all that. This poem is called Thinking, and when I think, I feel like I can be a part of a group, and the LSD family has really made me a part of that group. So that is why I chose this poem, because I really think that it reflects off of how I went through my high school years and really made me a better person, makes me think. Second thing I want to talk about is relationships, and it's really hard for me to really find the perfect relationship with myself and for other people because I can find it very hard to express myself to other people without having the fear of them judging me or, you know, leaving me because they think I'm boring or they think I'm, like, you know, weird. And I formed a lot of relationships with a lot of people at LC, and it's really hard to pick just two to talk about. The first one I would want to talk about is my best friend, Casey. Casey and I became friends like freshman year. She came on my softball travel team and we started talking there. She went to Gwinnett for like half of a year of freshman year and then she transferred to LC. Her and I have been through everything. We've fought, we've, you know, talked about everything, we know about each other's lives, we know about what each other are going through. It's really easy to say that Casey is one of my closest friends. She has been there for me no matter what. She's helped me through my struggles, I've helped her through hers, and she is one of the most important relationships that I have formed in my high school year. The second person I'd have to pick that I formed a really close relationship with and has helped me through everything, even though it may seem a little bit cheesy, is my boyfriend Connor. He and I have been through so much. We've been together for almost 2 years now, and we have gone through many struggles. Our relationship isn't based off of couples, it's more based off of the support that we have for each other. He plays a sport and I play a sport, and we always push each other to do our very best. Same with school, we always push each other to study, we always push each other to, you know, get an assignment done even though we think that it's not worth it. The amount of support that we have for each other is just amazing. I think I would have never gotten through the last 2 years at LC if it weren't for him. I've struggled through a lot, and we both have very emotional pasts. He has a very emotional past, and I have a very emotional past that we both struggle with. But I feel that since we were together, we have helped each other through that and to look more on a positive note rather than looking in the past. So I really would like to thank Casey and Connor for everything that they've done for me. And without the relationship that I have with them, I really don't know how I would have gotten through high school. Now, when I talk about influences, two people definitely come into mind. And I want to talk about the one influence that definitely comes to mind. As many people already know, I am a huge football fan and my favorite team is the Philadelphia Eagles. Why am I mentioning that? My biggest influence is the quarterback, Carson Wentz. Carson is one of the people that I look up to the most because he is very close with his faith. He started on the Eagles, I think, in my freshman year. He has been the starting quarterback ever since, but the thing about him is that he doesn't take fame and, you know, the amount of money that he makes playing football. He doesn't you know, express that. He doesn't care about that. It's more about the message he's trying to send. Everything that he posts about is about walking in God's direction, speaking the word of God. And ever since freshman year, I've always looked up to him because I wasn't very close with my faith. During freshman year, I had a very difficult time for many reasons. I've always looked up to him and I wanted to become closer to my faith. The sky turns to a different shade of blue. Watching what he does and listening to the message that he spreads to everyone, I've become very close with my faith, and that really helped me out through freshman and sophomore year. He always had something to say. He always had something positive to say for anybody who was struggling, for anybody who was having a hard time dwelling on the past. It was just something that I could always watch or look at him. Going on about his faith, he also has a foundation that he runs that he started in his college year after one of the football players asked him in the locker room if he's ever read the Bible. His foundation is called the AO1 Foundation, and I have been following that foundation for about 2 years now. I've gone to the AO1 charity softball game, and their mission statement is uplifting individuals and communities around the world by demonstrating God's love for his people. Just reading that and thinking about it, it's just so powerful. You know, I'm in God's path, and Carson Wentz really delivers that message very well. When talking about my second biggest influence, I immediately think of my mom. That may seem like, you know, everybody says their mom, or everybody says their family, or everybody says their siblings, but this is different. For me, my mom has always been there for me. She understands my struggles that many people don't understand, like my ADHD, and she understands how I'm very shy and I can't really step outside my own comfort zone. She would come and comfort me, and she wouldn't say, you know, it's gonna be okay, like it's not your fault, you know, just go through the motions. No, she would look me in the eye and she would say, Meg, you gotta learn how to deal with it. And yeah, in the moment, it may seem like a really like, thanks, mom. But at the same time, it was like, wow, like I really do need to work on it. Just her being very honest with me and being very supportive with everything I do, such as softball and school, and you know, really helping me out through everything, I can't thank her enough. And she is one of the biggest influences on my life. And I think without her, I wouldn't be where I am today. I wouldn't have the things that I have today. And I wouldn't be as successful as I am today. So, if anything, a huge thank you to my mom. I have made a lot of memories at LC, and it's so hard just to pick four. Just narrowing it down to four is just so hard for me to do, but the only four that I can think of, I will list from, you know, number four to number one. Number one being the most important. So, starting at number four is the Bonner Prendy game, 2018. This was just a huge game for me. During regular season, when we played Bonner Prendy, we actually lost in the last inning, in the eighth inning. I was pitching and a girl hit a walk-off home run on me to end the game, and it was really sad. But anyway, ever since then, I've had like that, I want a rematch with them, and we did. And it was on my birthday, and my coach said, you know what, Meg, you're pitching, go in. And I was so excited. In the first four innings, we scored 15 runs. And it was like the best feeling ever. I'm like, oh my gosh, like, yes, we got him back. We ended up winning that game. After winning that game, it was a great feeling afterwards. So going on to number three, a memory I'll never forget was in 2019 when I was in Florida and I played my last travel softball game. I wouldn't consider this technically a happy memory, but it's definitely something that I will learn from and is very important to me because it was one of the biggest moments in my life where I made a decision on my own, the biggest decision that would most likely lead to my future. I played softball all my life. You know, going from a different team and having a back injury, it was my decision that I was just done. I wasn't happy anymore. And yeah, it was emotional, but I would never take it back for the world. I am very confident in the decision I've made, and it's something I'll never forget because if I can make that decision, I can make other kinds of decisions. So next at number two, as one of my favorite memories is a little bit more recent, it just happened, was my 18th birthday. We're stuck in quarantine, it stinks, but it was probably one of the best days ever. From the morning, I woke up with balloons all in my kitchen and I received a lot of text messages and I got a lot of shout outs saying, you know, happy 18th birthday, you deserve it. It was really awesome. And then later in that day, I was surprised by a birthday parade. A bunch of my friends came around the circle in my neighborhood and they were honking their horns saying happy birthday. My family filmed the whole thing and they filmed my reaction. And it was just the best thing ever. Even though I couldn't see all of my friends at school or a lot of my family, even though I couldn't physically be in 6 feet away from them, but it was really awesome to see them. And finally, at number one, as my favorite memory ever, and that's something I will never forget, is Kairos. And I'm sure many people will probably say that or it influenced them, but Kairos is something I will never, ever, ever forget. And maybe I can't say why, and I don't want to spoil the surprises. It was just something that was very, very impactful on me, and I will never forget it. I went into Kairos feeling a little bit scared because I see many people coming out and, you know, they're all happy and they're all like hugging each other, and I was going in kind of like, I don't think this is what's gonna happen to me. But then by the second night, I was chi high. I never wanted to leave. It was the best thing ever, and I wouldn't trade it for the world, and it's something that I will be mentioning in my 30s and my 50s, saying how it's the best thing ever. I would never regret it, and if I could, I would want to go back on it. So in closing, my future plans is to attend DeSales University as a TV film major, and hopefully after I graduate, I will be working on set of a movie or commercial. And if I do get a job as that, I would want a side job as doing photography for weddings or for portraits, if anybody wants to do like a graduation portrait. I think that would be awesome. I just want to say on a final note, without LC, I wouldn't be where I am today. The LC community has taught me so much. I've become very close with a lot of teachers and a lot of my friends. I will always, always, always love LC and everything that you have done for me. So thank you.